this is Domingo. I'm a student studying in NTU. I come from Taichung, and now I'm living in Taipei. Taipei is a city full of many interesting things, that you can find many interesting things here. As I say, I'm a student, and I have many hobbies. I love reading, I love writing, and especially I love dancing. However, today we are not talking about dancing,We are talking about dumplings.
Hello everyone. My name is Hendra Ramdhani. I'm a student at Tanjung Pura University, Pontianak. Through this international showcase of visual ethnography, I will show to you all about traditional food in West Kalimantan. That's all in Pontianak.Takeaway and bubur pedas.
But food is important to every one of us. Each day, people crossing Lane 118 to buy their breakfast, lunch, dinner, or even they just want to grab a snack. Here is Dali Dumpling, an old famous dumpling house in Lane 118. They are famous for their dumplings.I will ask the hostess about Dumpling House and her story. But because the hostess is too shy, hence I accompany the interview with the scenery I wrap the dumplings.
好，那你们这边开了的？
这家店的话有十几年了。
哦，十几年。
我中间有换过老板，啊，这次的老板是大概做四年，四年左右。
嗯。因为就是以前大家对水饺的印象大概都是可能外省的二代这样子，你们这家也是就是外省？
不是
哦，不是哦，是本省的。
对，就是我们这家应该是外省。对，我们是接他们的那个什么味道去做掉。
就是外省的味道
啊。
那你们就是常常就是学生之间都会就是说你们跟李记好像有关系，但是真的有关系吗？
以前的老板就是李记
啊。哦，以前的老板就是李记。
就是他们这边顶给我们之后，他们好像就是中间有休息，然后就再来去那个转角那边开李记。
嗯。
他们的味道是相似的，但是不同家，就是我们是认识，只是不同的老板这样。
哦，就也不是什么兄弟关系，
不是没有
关系。哦，OK， 好，那就是你本人在这家店大概工作多久？
我也是从这家店开始，我就在这边帮忙。
哦，就是十几年这样子。對對
對，没有，我是后面的老板。
哦，好，
接近四年这样子。
嗯。好，那就最后想请问，就是说，那水饺对你的意义是什么？就是。你包水饺给大家吃会很快乐吗？还是你自己也会吃自己做的水饺？
会啊。
哦。
我也是那种家庭主妇。
嗯。
刚好小孩子也是爱吃，所以我就是用那种家庭的概念做出来的水饺。
嗯。
反正我就是要做给我小孩子吃。
比较有家的味道。
嗯。
那你小孩都喜欢吃什么口味？
哦，两个不一样，一个喜欢高丽菜，一个喜欢韭菜。
哦，因为疫情，然后客人的数量有变少。
有。
哦，有。
嗯。
是因为本来都是学生这样子。
对，因为我们本来就做学生，那你排单一休息的话，学生不在，我们当然
会
有单。
哦。
嗯。但是像阿玉是一样，是一样，那是我们的性质不同。
大理水饺的常客嘛。
还算长吧，
嗯，
不过没有到很长啊。
嗯，那你最喜欢吃什么水饺？
就是韭菜跟高丽菜。
哦，韭菜跟高丽菜、啊。好，那就是最后想问你说，就是吃水饺，就是对你自己的意义是什么？就是你的感触，还是就是很平常的，就是吃个饭？
就蛮平常的吧。
嗯。
然后就水煮也不会太油这样。
然后就是都一个人吃这样。
Pontianak is the capital of West Kalimantan. This city is known as the City of the Equator. In Sharta, there is an Equator monument which is close by the Equator. Pontianak is multi-ethnic city. It's not surprising that the city has various cultures and religions, such as Malay, Dayak, and Chinese. Okay everyone, we are in one of the restaurant that Prophet Bingka Pontianak. That's in Pontianak. Bingka cake or Bingka cake is made from mixture of eggs, coconut milk, wheat flour and sugar. The Bingka cake will usually be baked twice. This is made so that the cake has the right level of perfectly cooked Bingka cake will usually have a color combination of light brown and dark brown. That's why it takes a high level of patience when making it. It will take at least an hour for the Bingka cake to be ready to eat. You can taste it in various creations, from Bingka tape, potatoes, pumpkin, pandanus, jackfruit, young coconut, chocolate, and cheese. In the past, this cake was a typical Ramadan snack in the Pontianak area. But now, we can easily find Bingka cake in regular mall, because this cake with a sweet taste and soft texture is no longer just a food for breaking the fast, but has become a souvenir for tourism.
Many people would rather choose the way of cooking dumplings by themselves to reduce the possibility of contacting to the virus. Now we are heading forward to Ayu Shuijiao. It's another kind of dumpling house that sells wrapped dumplings. Let us see how the hotels think about the pandemic.
就疫情下的话，我们这边跟疫情有正相关。疫情如果很比较严重的话，我们这边生意会变得比较好。对，因为大家就是不想要去餐厅吃饭啊，所以就是会买水饺去，就在家里自己煮。对，那如果疫情舒缓，就会我们这边就是会变得就跟比较趋向正常这样子，大概就这样。
那就是来买的大概都是自己回去包，还是就是已经买现成？
我们只有我们这边都是已经包好的，然后客人只要自己回去煮就可以了。对。
好，那最后就是问一下，你在阿姨水饺大概待了
多久？大概多久？十几年吧。
十几年。那这家店是三？
这家店应该已经三十年以上。
三十年。好。
对。大概就是这样。
And let us see how the client think about dumplings and the pandemic.
你是台大的学生吗？
不是。
不是。那你为什么会来买阿姨水饺？
因为我妈妈的同事介绍的，然后吃过之后也觉得好。
那你们都吃什么口味？
就是吃香菜那个吧，就是香菜，就是其实都可以吃，就是都
可以吃。好，那就是说是因为疫情，然后才买水饺回家自己吃。
没有，因为现在暑假，通常暑假中午都在家里自己弄，所以水饺比较好一点。
OK， 好，谢谢。
We are going to other place in West Kalimantan, that is Singkawa. Welcome to Singkawa. Singkawa is one of the cities in West Kalimantan. This city is famous for its three main tribes. There are Malay, Dayak, and Chinese. This is because most of the residents here is China. Singkawang is also known by many names, from Amoy City, City of Thousand Temples, and Hong Kong Fun Burger. We are going to famous restaurant in Singkawang. This is very famous Chai Kueh restaurant in Singkawang. This restaurant is 118 years old. So it's very popular with people in Singkawang. This house was built by Cici Yahya Pseng 19 years ago. Chai pan or chai kueh is one food that is very synonymous with the city of Pontianak, West Kalimantan.
Rendang mempunyai rasa yang khas bang dan juga merupakan makanan tradisional di Singkawang. Jadi saya suka dan isiannya juga enak bang, bengkoang gitu.
Eksistensi dari makanan choy pan ini di kota Singkawang sendiri itu sudah sangat terkenal. Namun di beberapa kota yang ada di Kalimantan Barat belum cukup terkenal. Nah, jadi pemuda di Singkawang berupaya untuk mengembangkan makanan choy pan agar dapat dikenal ke seluruh kota yang ada di Kalimantan Barat.
Choy pan itself is a type of dim sum that contains vegetables and is cooked by steaming. The filling is usually varied, ranging from bongkoang and taro, mixed with dried shrimp or bamboo soup, and sliced seed. While the skin is made from a mixture of rice flour and sago flour to produce a smooth and chewy skin texture, then the outside is covered with garlic oil and fried garlic.
Skins of the dumplings, and this is cabbage and pork stuffing, and this is chive and pork stuffing.
This is my second time that I wrap dumplings myself. I don't think it's a very challenging work, but I think that the stuffing is very, you know, stinky.
Wrapping dumplings is an easy work. Sometimes it can be very tedious, which makes me think of my college life, going to school, classes, studying, examining, writing papers. Even though it's kind of boring, there still are some enjoyable moments. Let us see these interesting moments. Appreciate these cuties I made. Through this film, do you know dumplings better? Maybe next time you can get in one of these dumpling houses I recommended you, or buy ingredients yourselves and wrap them with your family.
Next, we will head to Sambas. Welcome to Sambas. Sambas is also one of the cities in West Kalimantan. The city has a motto that is Red Sambas. In the past, this district was still part of Singkawang District until 2000. It became its own district, namely Sambas District. Sambas means the land of three tribes, namely Sam, which means tree, and Bas, which means ethnic city. The majority of the tribes here is Malay, Dayak, and Tionghoa, or Indonesian Hakka. In Sambas, it's famous for its bubur pedas. Let's go! The ingredients of this food are long bean, kale, corn, and the most important is kusum leaves. Mix all about 15 minutes on the fire. According to community stories, bubur pedas used to come from the Malay tribe who live in the Singkawang, Pontianak, and surrounding area. In the past, this porridge would only be cooked during royal ceremonies or traditional ceremonies that were sacred. Even during war, this bubur pedas was made as a method to save food costs when the people in Sambas Regency were fighting the invaders. The word pedas is parable of the Malay tribe which mean the various vegetables and spice found in the food. The large number of spice and vegetables that are mixed together, therefore, this food is considered to contain a lot of nutritional value. The distinctive aroma that comes from the leaf of kusum and also the turmeric leaf, which are cooked and smooth, and the mixture with other ingredients.
Dari luar yang biasa suka nanya bubur pedas, ada mbak, ada bubur pedas kan khas Sambas, jadi yang bisa dijual ya. Oh, yang jauh kan biasa nanya. Jangan lupakan makan bubur pedas. Nih bubur pedas, makanan tradisional Sambas.
Okay, it's near the end of the ethnographic film.
So the research, right? I would like to thanks to National Taichung University Taiwan and Tsinghua University
and for hosting this workshop,
for giving me the opportunity to improve my skills in the world of filmmaking. I apologize if there are words and behavior that are not pleasing to all of you.
And thank my partner Hendra for cooperating hard with me in this film introducing Indonesian cuisine and Taiwanese dumplings. I'm Domingo Wong. Gracias. Hasta la vista.
I'm Hendra Abdani. Thank you.